It's raining. It's raining in California. Yes, it is. Oh, I cut all my hair off for the trip and then we didn't go, but just the same, I like it better now. It's raining. It's raining in California. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's raining in California. Yeah, I've still got my cold. Kind of a bummer. But that's the way it is. You get colds and you get colds. I had to skip Thanksgiving dinner. We're gonna go to my stepsister's house. Her son, who got married a couple years ago, and his wife, they came down. There was 25, 26 other people at that dinner. My stepsister and her husband always put on a big Thanksgiving dinner. We used to go all the time until my stepfather died, and then we started going up into Riverside, hanging out with my brother and his wife and her brother and sister and mom. They all live up there. Well, not her brother. He's passed away about 2 years ago. Once or twice I took Terry up there with me. And then, a couple years ago, Mom started saying she didn't want to drive all the way up there just to sit down and eat dinner. So this year we were going to go out to my stepsister, brother-in-law's house, and out in the hills just beyond the edge of the city. And I was looking forward to that. They've got a beautiful house. It's not big or anything like that. Just 3 bedrooms, I think it is. But it's the lot it's on is a little larger than normal because it's not in the town. It's not in the city. It's out beyond the edge of the city, out in this what they call village, rural village, unincorporated area. It's a place they call Jamul, Jamul. That's an old Indian word from the people who have lived around here for thousands of years. My stepsister's been upset for 10 years now because the Jamul Indians have been building a casino, and well, it finally opened, and all that traffic on the one road they have coming in and out of Jamul. It's a beautiful highway. Highway 94 goes back into the hills for miles after Jamul. Beautiful. Unless you get car sick from twisting around the corners. But, like I said, we didn't go because I got this damn cold. And I didn't feel like going out there and coughing and sneezing all over all those people. I thought that would be particularly rude, thoughtless, inconsiderate. Oh, yeah. And excuse me. Sometimes the mucus drips down the back. A little bit, a couple of drops from the back of my head go down, and they just irritate the living psychobabble fucking horseshit out of my bronchial tubes. Well, so we didn't go. And my stepbrother offered to take my mom out. She refused. She said no. Truth is, she doesn't really like to go out there. Oh, yeah. So that was my Thanksgiving. Now, my stepfather's niece, who's about my age, came by the day before Thanksgiving and brought us a whole bunch of Thanksgiving stuff. Turkey breast and some mashed potato mix. Vegetables, stuffing mix, and all this other stuff. So Mom and I had a little dinner on Thursday. Turkey breast, mashed potatoes, peas. So we had the taste of Thanksgiving. But we didn't have so much food as we had just giving thanks that we're alive, reasonably healthy, except for the darn cold. We're not rich or anything, but we got a beautiful house to live in. The mortgage was paid off, my God, 30 or 40 years ago. So we can get by. We could never afford to live here if we had to pay for it. My God. The house next door, right over there, that house sold few years ago for almost $1 million. And it's a small house as they go around here. It had two bathrooms, three bedrooms, a small living room, a small kitchen, and a one-car garage. I mean, it was built like in 1953 for $10,000. And because of the view, you've seen the view, I've shown you out there, and then there's out in front too. Because of the view, it's a $1 million property. Well, go figure. Like I said, we couldn't afford to live here, so that's something to be thankful for, that we have this beautiful home. As long as my mom lives. And then I'll have to take all of her stuff out, leave the house to my stepbrothers and stepsister. Their dad, in his will, wrote that my mom could live here as long as she wanted to. But he didn't say I could. So, it's the bye-bye, Daddy. And that means I get to go back to Mexico. Oh, God willing. That's something else to be thankful for, you know. That I have a talent with languages and a love of Mexico. And I've been able to do something with that. Just the other day, I made that video about finding an apartment for rent in way down in Mexico in the city of Puebla for 2,700 pesos, which is $140 a month. And I only had 5 or 6 translation jobs last month, but oh no, in the last 3 months. And I only made 5, 6, 7,000 pesos, but I could have paid for my rent and my food with that. So the problem is that I'm getting old, and I have Medicare because I turned 65. Was it last year or year before last? Last year. But you can't use American Medicare in Mexico. No. So that'll be an issue. But I do have my apartment in Tijuana that used to be my friend Terry's apartment. And I'm still paying for that. $350 a month. Now that's expensive for Mexico, but it's a big apartment. She wanted to have lots of rooms when we first moved in there. I had my room, and there was a big bedroom that we both slept in. And then there was a third bedroom with a huge closet. That was her dressing room. She's a fancy girl. I miss her. Just possible she was the last woman I'll ever have a relationship with. I'm such a selfish loner. Anyhow, I'm thankful for my love of Mexico and my ability to speak Spanish, understand it, find work as a translator from Spanish into English. And since we didn't spend a lot of time making pigs of ourselves out of a big meal, I can't talk either. I'm gonna have to stop this. I just really wanted to show you the rain. And now it's been too long. So I didn't make a pig out of myself over Thanksgiving, but I have been thinking about things to be thankful for. And before I go, I just want to say I'm thankful for you, my friends. We've had several years now, almost 10 years, talking to each other, this internet stuff. So, I'll say goodbye, and God bless.